Yeah, welcome to the Green Cultural Centre's book club, and today's book we're going to look at is On Mars Table, and I'll just give a quick summary of the book to begin with, and then we're going to explore some of the main topics and themes of the novel, and then at the end we're going to have a sort of a brief question and answer section as well. Just a quick summary. I mean, I'm assuming we all do our homework. We read the book as well.
Yeah, that's
good to know. Yeah. Sometimes people fake. They come in and they're like, "Oh, I know that part," but that's okay. The graphic novel focuses on Madan, who is like a new father and also an artist who moves out to the quiet countryside, and it's basically focuses on his struggle between starting a new family and also taking care of his aging parents who are, you know, they're encountering more health problems, and it's that tension in between his duties as a father, but also as a son. And I think, I'm not sure about you, my personal impression of the book was, I didn't expect it to get so heavy, so quickly, and touch on these themes. And I'm an Australian born Korean, but there were some topics and themes of like family tension that I really related to. And first of all, it's very like unexpected because you look at the characters' faces and they're cats, you know? They're just having fun, they're very childlike, but it does talk about those serious things. So my personal connection and impression of the book was I really loved it and enjoyed how disarming it is in exploring those serious topics. Hannah?
Did you like the book? Is there anyone who didn't like the book? It's okay not to like it.
Yeah, very brave person, but I hated it.
Yeah.
Well,
I must say, when I read it, and I did read it in about 3 sittings, sort of in the middle, I kind of thought, halfway through, I thought, no, I didn't like it. And then I finished it, and then I thought, okay, that was very sad, very moving. But then when I finished and put it down, I couldn't help but think about it.
Yeah.
And it was like I kept thinking about it. I kept thinking about, you know, the family relationships. I kept thinking about Madame's role and struggles as a father and a husband and as a child. As aging parents.
Yeah.
The title of the book is Oma's Table. Oma means mom or mummy. So it's actually not mother. So mother is Omoni. So I think the title sort of implies the really close relationship that Madame had with his mom. Do you know in Korea, the book's title is Madame's Table.
Yeah, it's different. Yeah, they translated it to Madame's Table.
So, I can throw a question to you. Why is the title different? In Korea, the original title is Madame's Table. And I think in Paris, correct me if I'm wrong, if you know French, it's Kimchi's Taste.
Kimchi's Taste, which is even more different.
Yeah.
Well, actually, now that we've come across this first little maybe discussion point, like, what do we prefer out of those three? Like, we've got Kimchi's Taste, Madame's Table, and Omma's Table. Was anyone surprised that the original name was not Omma's Table? I found that very surprising because I thought originally, it being called On Mars Table makes so much sense because the mum is such a central character, and also the cooking, while it's not all about food, it's about the table as a sort of theme of where everyone would sort of gather, they share, they eat food, the connection to family. And I guess what we discussed earlier, we've had a couple of discussions about the book, but earlier we talked about how it's his mum's table because she was the cook. Like the main chef of the family, but he then kind of takes the torch, doesn't he? And doesn't that the lineage of cooking pass through him? And so then when Heather told me the original name is Madame's Table, maybe that's an idea of saying it was his mum's table and now it's his. Because we are thinking about family and we are thinking about how things progress and how they're passed down. So I thought that was a fascinating bit of trivia. And hey, we've only started talking about the title of the book, and we need to start cracking into the beef and potatoes of it.
Yeah. I mean, it's a graphic novel, but we could be here all night talking about it. There's so much in here to talk about. But let's put it to
I was really curious as well. How many of you can, even just so it's caught on the YouTube video here, can anyone give a clap for, like, if you've eaten Korean food before? Just give it like a round of applause. Okay, good. And you'd be very, very surprised if you hadn't. So I have another question, and this might be trickier. Give me a round of applause if you've had homemade Korean food before. That's fantastic. For those of you who didn't clap, I don't want to be like, bleh, suck it. But I think that's an important part of this book, don't you think, in terms of the experience. Obviously, eating Korean food is a very good way to connect to the content of this graphic novel, but the idea of eating something that someone's made for you, and even if it's someone that's very close to you, is just another thing altogether.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, food has always been a proxy for love in Korean culture, like in most culture. And like in Korea, and even like Koreans around the world, you know, we actually greet each other saying, have you eaten?
Yeah, that's right.
And, you know, we can't really say, a lot of the older generation can't say, I love you, thank you, or sorry. So food is a proxy for all of those things.
I remember, you know when you get into an argument with your parents or whatever? Like, this would happen to me, I'd have an argument with your parents, and you're like, dad wouldn't apologize, mom wouldn't apologize, but then later you're in your room studying or whatever, and she'd come with a plate of fruit. I'm gonna be like, that was the little white flag. Like, I feel, you know, I am sorry. You know, I care about you. Because in essence, food is what keeps us alive. And they're trying to, you know, nourish us. They're trying to support our, you know, healthy way of living. But again, I think it's so fascinating how, it's almost like a misdirection. The idea that this is, when you look at the cover and the title, you think this is all about food. But really, it's about family relationships.
Yeah, I definitely agree with you, Harry. Is there anyone amongst you that want to talk about the food for a start?
Yeah.
Is there, I mean, for me, the big part of it was kimchi making.
Yes.
Did everyone enjoy that? Mm. Yeah. So would anyone like to sort of, you know, digress from there?
Were you one of the people that, have you had homemade Korean food before?
I have.
Oh, fantastic, great. Do you have a favourite Korean food? That's a tough question.
I mean, I love bibimbap and...
Oh, yeah, great.
Some of them are like two favourites, I think.
Yeah, fantastic.
I think, tied into your question before about the title, I think tying that back to the theme of food that's through this, I think Oma's Table, using that as kind of a framework for the book and the food kind of keeps it in this area of memory and this sense of, this kind of sentimental reading of food. And so when you kind of finish the book, you're left thinking about mom and her legacy.
Yes.
Whereas if it's Madame's Table, there's kind of an aliveness and a hope, I think, if that's the framework that you're looking at the novel through, with the idea of food and those kind of last images. On the last couple of pages, it's him and his family and his son Iwan and his wife, and he's like, now let's eat. And so you kind of, just hearing that new title, I'm like, oh, now I could, you know, I'm seeing like a torch being passed on that maybe I didn't get in the first reading because of this particular title related to food.
I really like how you frame it in, it's the contrast between looking in the past and looking to the future.
Yeah.
Because the title does affect that as well, and that idea of lineage and legacy.
Yeah, and I think that's tied into the familial relationships, you know, the family tensions that you're talking about too. You definitely feel this push and pull, because there's lots of flashbacks in the book as well, where you can see a young Madame, and how his mother was such a central part of his world and his home life, and then how her role has changed, as his role has changed, he's kind of stepped into her place, and she's kind of flipped over to the other side, and he's kind of in this place, and he's torn between, you know, wanting to be with his family, kind of being that central person in their life, but also having to take care of an ailing mother who can no longer provide for him what she used to.
Yeah.
So the idea of legacy, I think, is really interesting.
Yeah, yeah. We're going to explore that.
We'll explore.
Yeah.
And I think we'll come back to food as well.
Yeah, as well.
Should we talk about